What's up, people? Coach Pat coming at you with another video, another pros and cons video. Today we are going to be discussing yet another Bluetooth speaker. What I have right here in my hands is a Tech 2. They call it the tube, I guess, because it is tube-like. It's actually pretty nice in size. Is it worth it? How much did I pay for it? Is it good enough? We'll find out. Hi, hello, and what's up, everybody? Welcome to PC by CP, or Pros and Cons by Coach Pat, where I give you real-life evaluations on everyday products. If you enjoy the video, hit that like button, and please don't forget to subscribe. Thanks. So, let's get started. We're going to be talking about this tube wireless Bluetooth speaker from Tech 2, I guess is the brand. That's what the sticker says anyways. And the other day I was shopping and I found this at Ross, out of all places. I was there shopping with my daughter and I saw this little speaker. They had a couple different kinds at this little section, like a techie section. And I saw the price and I was like, you know what? Maybe it's worth a shot. $22.99 is what I paid for it. The sticker right here says $22.99, and comparable value, it says $35 there on the sticker from. So I don't know if it's really worth $35 or not, like retail price, but I paid $22.99, so $23. And so, first pro, price. I think I got a good deal. I've gotten other speakers in other places, paid a lot more for this one. $23, it's actually not bad for a Bluetooth speaker, especially this size. Has a lot of nice little features. First of all, the you can plug in a USB drive into it, your aux cable if you're gonna plug it into your phone. You got your micro SD charger and you got a micro SD card if you want to have all your audio files in a little micro SD card. The sound quality is not bad, but for number one, for starters, I kind of like this speaker. When you turn it on, this section right here has all the buttons. I thought it was going to be like a handle you can pull out, but no, it's all the buttons that you have here to press. The bad thing is that you can't really see them. I guess since it's camouflage and I can't see it, or maybe I need my glasses. Well, yeah. Maybe I just need to go get new glasses. So let's see, people. Power button. So when you power it on, let's see if you guys can hear this.
The Bluetooth device is ready to pair. The Bluetooth device is connected successfully.
So it connected automatically to my phone, and it does light up. I guess you can make your phone calls through this. It does show you the little Bluetooth symbol when it is connected. And there's two volume buttons, minus and plus. If you press the plus once, you change the track. If you press and hold, you actually change the volume. So if you press and hold, that tells you that it's at full volume. And if you just press once like this, kind of tap it, you're changing the track, you know, going forward or going backwards. But so it is kind of an decent size speaker. So the quality of the music, of the sound coming out of it, is not bad. Not bad at all. I'm going to show the dimensions and all that good stuff, what it came with. Came with a little charging cable and a super short aux cable. So I guess you plug it in and your phone has to be like 5 inches from the device, which is kind of inconvenient. But we are trying to use this as Bluetooth, so it doesn't really matter for me. Not much of a something to pick at. It's not even a con, because I don't want to use a cable. I want to use Bluetooth. So for me, that cable is almost like a throwaway cable. So again, this part back here, you got all your things that you can connect to it. And over here is your buttons, what they do. They do light up, so I do like that about them, that when you finally press it, the icon does light up and it's easier to see when they're off. It's really hard to see because it is camo, people. It's camo, so I guess you're not supposed to see it. The back ends are just the plastic, so they're not speakers that move as the vibration of the sound. you know, it's coming out, so they don't, you know, shake here. They don't move. It's just a plastic cover. We're going to check out some sound. For another pro, though, I love the look of this. This camo, easy to carry. You know, if you're going to your pool, you can just throw it out there. It is really good. If you're going to have a little get-together out by the pool, you're going to have a drink, you want to listen to some good music, bam. It is really nice. And that camo, even nicer, people. I love this. I think it looks super cool. So that's definitely a pro for me, that it looks so friggin' cool. So we're going to check out some sounds. Let's see what you guys think. So I got the speaker about 5 inches from the microphone, or the main microphone of the telephone. And as you can see right now, there's a 40 decibels from just the AC and the regular sounds coming out. My voice is projecting a little bit of sound there, so I'm gonna try to be quiet while I play some music for you guys. And while my dog kind of growls in the background too.
Hey guys!
So as you can see, it was about 80 decibels with that distance, which ain't bad. All right, people, coming back at you with a sound test. So I am gonna put it close to my microphone. I got my phone right here. I'm gonna play a little music. Maybe it's not your taste of music, but man, you can't go wrong with a little country, especially some Chris Stapleton. That dude is amazing. So. So, you got a little taste of it, how it sounds. It is pretty loud. There's not that much deep bass, but you can hear the difference in the sounds, but the highs and the mids are really clear. One thing I really like, so that's another pro right there. Mids and highs, they're clear, especially if you're gonna, you know, this is not a boom box that, you know, again, for parties, and especially if you're not gonna, you know, you're not gonna be a DJ with this kind of speaker anyways. But if you just want to have a little get-together, you know, outside, by the pool, by the yard, have a drink here and there, relax, put some music, perfect speaker. So the other thing is, it is not waterproof. So that is a con. So let's go hit some cons right now. The part, the section where it has to plug in your aux, your USB, micro SD, and your micro SD card, it's not covered. So if water splashes on it, even a little light rain or even a light little sprinkle, water will get in there. So it's definitely not waterproof. I know the box doesn't say anything about, you know, waterproof and all that, but I really wish it had a cover, because listen, I'm not throwing this in the pool, even if it was waterproof, but at least I would like to have some protection to where the electricity goes in, right? When you're charging it, when you're charging port, your USB, even if it gets a little water, eventually it's gonna get some corrosion or something, so that's definitely a con for me. I wish it had it. The other con is that when the lights are off again, I couldn't see a damn thing. I didn't know which one was the power button, which one was the plus button. Yeah, I guess the power button is kind of hidden once you hit it, you know. Maybe it's just me, my eyes are just bad, so. I don't know if it's really a con, but I couldn't see it, people. It is camo, though. Maybe another color. It's easier to see. So I think those are really the only two cons that I really kind of bother me, especially that waterproof. It doesn't have to be waterproof. You don't have to submerge and this thing, and for it to keep on working, for it to be awesome. But I wish it had a little cover. So that kind of bothered me, especially if you're outside by the pool. You're going to get some splash, some water, and you're like in Miami. It rains any second of the day. So you never know. You know, you might get a little rain. Even if you're under umbrella, you're carrying it, you're bringing it inside, and it might get a little wet. So the other thing is that it is a little larger than some other Bluetooth speakers. So it is not heavy, but it's not super light, and it doesn't have a handle. So I wish it had like a little handle, like a little rope or something that you can carry it easier. Yep, my doggy agrees. She's there saying, yep, I agree. She wants that rope. She can bite on it and chew on it and eat it like a spaghetti. They want to fight. Yeah, they want to fight. Guys, all right, back to it. So those are really the only cons. The sound level, it's pretty loud, or is loud enough. Again, this is not to throw a major party. You're not going to be a DJ with this kind of speaker. If you want to take it to the beach, that kind of sound is perfect. It's loud enough that you're going to be able to enjoy the music, but you're not going to be bothering people, you know, half a mile away, and they're going to be running away from you because they don't like your taste in music. Hopefully, you guys enjoyed the video. Hopefully, you guys see that, to me, it is worth it for $23. I think I got a good deal, and I love the look of it. I think it's pretty cool. So, once again, if you like my video, give me that thumbs up, and please, don't forget to subscribe. Thanks.